In this video, we're going to show you how to take a scrap of wood, a sheet of plastic, and a little bit of hardware to make a microscope that works with your cell phone. The supplies for this project are simple and easy. We have a sheet of clear plastic, a scrap of wood board, a little bit of hardware, and a laser pointer and a flashlight. And of course, since that's how this microscope works, we're also going to need a cell phone with a camera. First, grab your sheet of plastic. This one is an 8x10 sheet of acrylic from Lowe's that only cost a few bucks. These sheets of plastic usually come with protective layers on both sides. It's time to peel those off. Place your cell phone face down on a surface that won't scratch the screen. Then take your plastic sheet and line it up on top of the phone, leaving enough space on both sides so you'll be able to add support points. Using a marker that will draw on the plastic, mark a spot where your phone's camera is. This model of phone has two cameras on the back, so I'm making sure to mark the one that's used for narrower shots, not the wide-angle lens. In a line with where you've marked your camera, mark two spots on the sides where you can add your supports. You'll be drilling holes into the plastic about 1/4 inch wide, so make sure you leave enough space. Add one more support point down near the bottom of the phone as well. You should now have four spots marked out in your plastic where you're going to drill holes. But before you do any drilling, you need to cut out a rectangle that completely contains those points. There are several ways to cut acrylic. I find the easiest for a sheet this thickness is to score the plastic with a sharp knife and then bend it over a hard corner. Don't throw away those pieces that you broke off because we are going to use them later. The four holes you marked in your plastic will be used for different things. The two on the outside at the top and the one at the bottom will be used for the supports that hold up the entire plastic frame. This one in the middle, however, is going to be used to hold a focusing lens that lets your phone camera see much, much closer than normal. The three support holes need to be the right size to fit your hardware. The ones I'm using are 1/4 inch bolts that are 5 inches long. With your acrylic sheet cut, you now want to cut your board to be just a little bit larger. Mark where you need to cut it so that there's plenty of space, but it's not too cumbersome. You'll want the holes in your plastic and the holes in the wood board to line up perfectly. So take some strong tape and attach the acrylic sheet to the board temporarily. We now want to drill through our acrylic sheet and our first board with a scrap piece of wood behind it to make sure we don't drill into the workbench. Drilling through acrylic can be tricky because it does have a tendency to crack if you try and drill too quickly. So use a sharp drill bit and go slow. With those three holes drilled, you can remove your tape and separate your plastic from the wood. The last hole that needs to be drilled into the acrylic doesn't necessarily need to be the same size as the three support posts. What it needs to be is the same size as the lens that we're going to fit into the plastic. To measure that, we first need to remove it from where it's hiding. These little keychain laser pointers have been around for quite a while, and while they may have been expensive in the past, now you can get them for pretty cheap. I got this one at a pet store where it's sold as a cat exercising toy. As a first step, remove the batteries to eliminate any risk of shock. After removing the front tip, you should be able to see a black housing. Our lens is hidden down inside there. With a pair of needle nose pliers, let's just grip and twist. And on this, our lens just popped right out, literally popped right out. Here is the little lens that we're going after. In the laser, it's used to focus the beam into a tight point. You now want to drill a small hole where you marked your camera's position on your cell phone, the exact diameter of this lens that was removed from the laser pointer. On this setup, the 1/4 inch drill bit has made a hole that is almost the perfect size for our lens. So we're going to drill another hole that same size and then try just rotating the drill bit a little bit to widen the hole enough that our lens can fit in. You should now have a hole that your lens can fit into, but before you attach it permanently, you need to verify that you're going to have it facing the correct direction. Both directions will give you some magnification, but if you have your camera pointed in the wrong side, you'll have a very narrow area that's in focus. More of the screen should be in focus if the camera is looking in the correct direction. These lenses have two sides to them. One side is completely flat, and the other has a small ring going around a domed surface. You'll want your camera to be looking through the back of the flat side so that the curved side is facing whatever you're trying to look at. With the orientation of your tiny lens identified, you now want to press it into the drilled hole in the acrylic so that the domed side is facing what you're looking at and the flat side is facing your phone's camera. If you've drilled your hole out to the correct size, the lens should pop in and hold itself in place easily. With the hole for your lens drilled in your plastic, mark that circle on your board. The 3 5-inch bolts will work as support posts that hold your entire acrylic sheet up, but you'll want a way to look at slides and other things that you're seeing through your microscope. So now it's time to cut and add another piece of your acrylic sheet that will rest below the large one. This one won't have to reach all 3 posts, but will work just fine if it's only attached to the 2 in front. This piece will function as a shelf that we can put things on as we observe them through the microscope. Before we finish attaching all of the support hardware and the pieces that will hold our slide and main sheet of acrylic on top, we need to add a hole that will let us attach our light. This little press button flashlight is from the hardware store and only cost about $4. I like the compact design and the fact that the base is almost a perfect cylinder. Let's remove the key ring and then drill a hole into the wood platform that this can fit in. This 3/4-inch Forstner bit should be just the right size. The fit seems like it might still be just a little bit snug, so let's try and use some sandpaper to open that up. Our flashlight now fits snugly into the hole we just bored, and we can still access the trigger on the bottom. At this point, your board should be ready for assembly, but just to make it look a little bit nicer, let's sand down all of the edges and give it a shot of black paint. Fit the 3 posts through the holes in the board, and then add a washer and a nut to each one. Next, take 2 wing nuts and attach those upside down onto the front 2 posts. These 2 posts will work for both raising and lowering and focusing our slide. Our larger plate will fit over the slide to support the cell phone above it. To make sure our slide moves up and down a little bit more smoothly, let's add some small pieces of a spring in between our slide and the nuts that we'll add to attach our top sheet. Fit your flashlight into place and it should line up just right with your lens. As a final accessory, grab one of the remaining pieces of your sheet of acrylic and break it in half to use as 2 slides to hold things together in place under your lens. At this point, you should be able to turn on your phone's camera, line it up with the lens, and see a very up-close view of what's beneath. We have a few different items that we want to try looking at as up close as possible. Here's an extremely close-up view of part of a dollar bill. Why, George, what big eyes you have. Let's see what happens if we sandwich a flower petal in between our 2 slides and turn on the light behind it. You can actually make out the individual plant cells that the flower petal is made of. You can really see some pretty crazy details when you get this close. Here we've got a little bit of whatever kind of plant is growing in the water feature in the backyard. With this penny, we can see a lot of details not normally visible to the naked eye. For example, the tiny statue of the Lincoln Monument inside the building pictured on the back of the penny. This hands-on build is one that I found in an old issue of Make magazine, and it's really easy to build. Now you can use your cell phone to take extremely close-up pictures and video of things you can't normally even see. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you're not a subscriber yet, just hit the bomb to get in the club. If you missed our last video or want to watch it again, just click up here at the top. Click down there if you want to see what the internet thinks that you should watch next. That's it for now. Have fun, be safe, and see you tomorrow.